What up, what up, what up, what up, everyone? This is your boy Ice Revolver over here at another episode of AGN GAMECAST. Also on Facebook, you can catch us at AAA Gaming Network. Today I just want to hit on really a kind of a topic that's been going around because of the weekend, or over the weekend. We had the Anthem Demo, I guess. I want to say beta because it said weekend. Something I noticed when you start the game is it said weekends. So that tells me that there's going to be more than one playable weekend. So I don't know if it's a demo per se or kind of a beta. I think the game is about 3 weeks away though. So I don't know. You tell me. But yeah, I think a lot of people was playing the beta, man. I played it. I live streamed some footage of it. Long and short, I am a little impressed. The design of the map, the elevation, the ups and downs from underground caves and waterways to it's like sky bridges and various very high mountains that not only look pretty from a distance, you can actually go there. I'm wondering how you can actually go. Well, I guess your jets put a limit on that, but I like the overall gameplay. It feels nice. It reminds me of Warframe to a degree, but not as fast. So in a sense, it kind of reminds me a little of Titanfall when you're in your Titans, as far as movement go. Of course, this is a little looser, but I like it, man. I like it. There's a lot that we didn't get to see and experience. For those of you who played it, for those of you who didn't, there's a lot that they didn't show. Story, for one, the actual in-game currency, the in-game currency and the in-game premium currency system wasn't in full effect per se. You've seen a little of the regular in-game currency that you can earn, but not the currency that you can buy, but the currency, the in-game currency that you can earn. The spending system was toned down just for these demos / betas, these weekend plays, I'll call them. So we don't really know how much you'll need to earn per item, for what each item costs. Getting into that, a picture came up where it was costing an average of $20 in premium currency. So $20 for each 100 of these like purple shards, supposed to equal to a dollar, from the picture. I don't know, it's just from the picture, equal to a dollar. And some of these just the skins was costing 20,000 shards, which is $20, which is crazy. That's what's going on now. That's like the big deal, the big issue right now. BioWare, or representative of BioWare, did comment on it. It was on a Reddit post, I believe. Said that was just an iteration of the system. That's not the final deal. But I, my opinion, they can't have anything close to $20 a skin right now. A lot of people put in their opinions about just how wrong it is, or how egregious they feel as far as the asking prices of a lot of these things for a premium $60 game. But a lot of people didn't have actual solutions. A lot of people just stating the problem and not the solutions. I've seen a couple people state the actual solutions or come up with solutions or fair prices. Now, for these skins, I would agree around $5. I've seen a couple other people say this. An average of around $5 should be the most. Just a skin should cost. And the skins that I've seen didn't look fantastic. They looked like you just put paint on them, the same thing as we could do in the game, just put paint on them and you sold it for $5. Like, they didn't look like premium, like Supreme skins or Louis Vuitton or Gucci print skins or something like that. Like, and they was $20. So yeah, a skin will give y'all around $5. I would say no more than $5 for a skin. Just a skin for a javelin. And then they were selling some other things, just like paint jobs or little color wheels, kind of like a sphere. That's a color or a pattern that you can buy. I would say a few dollars, $2-3 maybe, but it has to go across all javelins that you use. You can't just use it for one javelin. But maybe I say $2, $5 for a skin, $2 for a color wheel, color pattern, or whatever you want to call it, things like that. $20 for a skin, you can't do. You telling me three skins is worth an entire another game? Is the price of an entire another game? Three skins is the price of the entire game itself. How is that equal? Like, even for this to be an iteration, how's the equal? I'll give you $60 for the game, and you give me all this content. And I'll give you another $60, and you give me three skins that look like I could have made on my own in like 2 minutes each. That's crazy. But to their credit, in the business, you do aim high, right? And you let people negotiate and bring you down lower. You don't start low, because then you might lowball yourself. You know, so they're trying to fill it out. It said that they didn't leak the pictures. I personally think that BioWare or DICE did. I mean, BioWare or EA did leak the picture, which is, in my opinion, would be an actual smart business tactic. You know, you leak the picture with the $20, you let people bring you down, negotiate, and then throw out their opinions of what they would pay, right? You might hear a lot of people say $10, and you might go with that, but originally you would have only selected five, right? And then if you'd have put that out there, people would have been like, oh yeah, okay, five, we set it on five. Then you just undercut yourself, because you could have sold it for 10, but you didn't let people bring you down. They just don't agree with what the lowest price is, or what a very low price is. So you aimed high and let the people talk you down. $20 for a skin, overpriced, severely overpriced. That's like almost a half price of a season pass for one skin. So no, hold on, let me get this water. So that's pretty much what I want to talk about. So yeah, $5 skins, man. $2 for anything that's lower than a skin, not price wise. If it don't live up to being a skin, It should be no more than the $5. So you can price everything else $2, $2.50, whatever. I don't care. Now, eventually down the road, if you guys want to sell javelins, maybe $20. If they're also balanced with all the other javelins, something like that, maybe. Because like, I think they're trying to do what Warframe kind of does, but Warframe, you know, not only is a free to play game. All the Warframes that you can buy, which are only prime Warframes that you can buy, you can also find the parts and build them yourself in game. So down the road, if they do something like that where they want to sell javelins, you should also be able to find the parts to build that javelin or to craft that javelin in game. That would be nice to have. But yeah, man, not too much. I like the gunplay. I like the weapons types that you can find, which is like pistols, assault rifles, submachine guns, LMGs, sniper rifles, grenade launchers. I like the fact that no matter what javelin you use and you find loot, all the javelins can use that loot, which is the weapons. You know what I mean? So that's nice. They are rarities from uncommons, or whites, greens, blues, purples, which is epic. Of course, blues are rare, and I'm guessing there's going to be some type of legendary or something that's higher than epic. I'm guessing that's normally how most loot systems have been going. There's always something higher than epic, which is normally something like an orange, and it's normally like a legendary title. I hated the loading real bad. To me, excuse me, for this to be an open world game, there was too much loading. Once you even load in the game, there's parts of the mission that loads. Like, oh, you got to get to this tunnel to start this. And then you wait to this long old loading screen that might give you an infinite load. Then when you do load, or you quit and reconnect and you load into the game, just to get to this part that's just having to be in a tunnel, you got to load again, which you might get another infinite loading screen. Who knows? Oh, my. It's too much loading. the world is huge. I give it that. Even just the thinking about the part that we could play, if you just think just about that area, and you look at the map, that was not a big area that we really explored. So I want to see the entire area. Most of the things I've seen look forested, so I really want to see a lot of the other map to see if there's a different vegetation in different places, if the map is actually different. Maybe goes from a jungle forest area to, do you have some type of ice cold area, desert type area, or an post-apocalyptic type of area or looking area, or whatever the case is. I just hope the entire map is not just like a big jungle. So that's one thing I'm looking forward to. Again, the elevation, the verticality of the map as a whole is ridiculous. Going from the top peaks of mountains to sea level land, and then being able to go down into caves and down further into like waterways, underground tunnel bunker looking things, which is like a whole nother living quarters looking thing. It's crazy the different levels in the game. So I'm really anxious to get my hands on that and play that, to see what I can find, see what everyone can find throughout these maps. What else I can think of? The javelins are nice. They're very different. I'm normally a heavy gunner. If you watch me play Black Ops, I play with an LMG majority of the time. I'm a heavy gunner. I'm a support player. I like to do a lot of damage. That's me. So I played with the initial javelin, which I forget his name. And then I played with the heavy, which is Colossus, which I think I'm going to play with the most. I didn't get a chance to play with the other two. I bought them, but I didn't play with them. The customization between your javelin's loadout is very nice. Between choosing two primaries to choosing what your abilities are with the both bumpers, or the left or the right bumper, or whatever the case is really nice. What I did find was weird was that when you go down, at the bottom of the screen it says spawning, but you never spawn, which is weird to me, right? That's weird that you say spawning, but the character isn't respawning. So I don't get that. And then in the middle of that same screen it says cannot be repaired, yet anybody in your team can come, and when they stand by you, it says they're repairing you to get you up. But you just said could not be repaired, and at the bottom you said respawning, but you never respawn, and then I am being repaired. I hope they do something about that screen. It was a little confusing. A lot of times when I thought I was respawning, I'm like, man, I'm respawning, and then I never respawned. Just do away with that. Unless the entire team go down, it shouldn't say spawning. Just do away with that entire bottom bar, because it doesn't make sense. And on the maybe cannot be repaired, maybe it's cannot be self-repaired, cannot self-repair, or whatever the case is. Said I would rather you phrase it like that, like, okay, I can't get myself up. Cool, I can't repair myself. I took too much damage. Cool, I gotta wait for somebody else to do it. But just saying cannot be repaired, and at the bottom telling me I'm respawning, gives me the sense that I'm destroyed pretty much. And I'm gonna be respawning. It's just the two screens, those two things together on the same screen is very confusing to me. But yeah, man, I really like the game. I'm really excited about the game. The weapon loadout customization, the paint jobs that you can do. You can customize your paint job from your legs, arms, your torso / chest, the head. It looks real slick. I like that. I like that a lot. And like I said, the shooting mechanics was solid, very solid to me. I'm not surprised that it's solid. I'm surprised because it's Anthem's first time out, but I'm not surprised because it's BioWare and they've made third-person shooting game. They made a lot of third-person shooting games. So I kind of expected it to be solid. But it was solid. The game was fun. The missions, though, were very repetitive. And I hope there's way more missions than that. I'm hoping the next time or the next weekend that we get it. Because like I said, on the screen it says weekends. So I'm guessing and hoping that there's going to be more of these weekends to play. Maybe because it's only like 3 weeks left. So maybe we just get a chance to play every weekend leading up until its release. Something like that. So, yeah. I hope that's not the only type of missions that's in the game. I hope they have a variety of missions, not just go here, shoot this, go here, shoot that, go here, shoot this. It's like pretty much all I did, or all everyone did, the entire 2 days. So I'm kind of worried about that, but other than that, man, it's pretty solid. Not too much to really say, much more to say. It was only 2 days, a very small portion, well, not a very small portion, but a small portion of the map that was available. Really couldn't get into details the way people really wanted to. Again, it's only 2 days, not really no one's fault. It's 2 days, man. So you only do so much in 2 days. But again, I'm hoping that they have more of these weekends, since it did say it on the screen. But yeah, man, let me know. Did y'all play the Anthem free play weekend, is what I'm gonna call it, the free play weekend? What was your thoughts? Did you like it? What's your issues with it? What did you really like about it? What did you love about it? What do you hope they change? How do you feel about these $20 skins? Let me know. Go over to the Facebook channel at AAA Gaming Network. Find this video and let me know over there. Find this podcast video over there and let me know in the comments below. And make sure you hit that like button. If you're on the podcast, that's for the people that's on the podcast, right? If you're on the Facebook page, hey, go check out the podcast, AGN GAMECAST. So whenever you don't have time to look at the video or listen to the video, whatever the case is, go over to the podcast on all platforms, Google, Apple, Spotify, Stitcher, TuneIn, whatever floats your boat. Check us out. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Every follower on Facebook helps us. Every subscriber on the podcast platforms, whatever platform you're on, helps us. Much appreciated. Make sure you leave a review too. If you listen to the podcast, we're only getting better with time, man. We're in our second season. The first season was only like a handful of episodes before the year ended. We're doing a lot of things different this season, this year, right? So make sure you leave a review. If you like us, make sure you leave a comment over on the Facebook page. If you have any issues, let us know, man. We always want to talk about it. We're here to talk about it. At the end of every description, it says, let's talk about it. So let's talk about it, man. This your boy, Revolver, man. Shout out AAA Gaming Network. Shout out AGN Podcast. Much respect. Much love, hey, everybody. Later.
Grand Peace. Theft Auto 3.
Word? Can I borrow that?
You got a PlayStation 2?
Nah, I got GAMECAST.
GAMECAST? Well, that's GameCube and then that's Dreamcast. What you got?
Well, I said I got GAMECAST, man. Damn, I can't afford it.
My bad. I'm just trying to help you out.